Hi team, hope you've had a good week. I've just finished my track session on Saturday. I had 10 400s planned, just nice and controlled, trying to accelerate through, but quads are a little bit sore from Rotorua, so I can only manage 8 before they start to cramp a little bit. So I think lesson in there is if there's a session planned and your body gives you signals otherwise, then make sure you listen to the body rather than the coach. So just note down what you've got done with quality. And then we can change it from there. So remember that nothing's ever written in stone. You've got to listen to your body first. Second thing is if you're using Garmin or Polar and you're doing a track session, or any session for that matter, and you've got a warm up in your main session and you warm down, and maybe some reps throughout that main session, whether it be hill reps or speed or drills or whatever, just make sure you keep it as one file. So that means start it and then just lap it in between those different bits of the session, and then stop it at the end of the warm down. Don't do a separate start, stop, save for each one of those. It's just really time consuming to try and assess the information. It's nice if you can get it in one file with one graph with intensity and heart rate if you've got it. It just saves a lot of time, and it's just a lot easier to keep that data then for later analysis. Okay, so there's your tips for the day. If your body is tired or you've got sore muscles from a race or from a big session on the weekend and you've got something planned in the coaching and you can't do it, then just listen to your body. That's the main thing, okay? Listen to your body's signals rather than my plan, and then just change it. And then second of all, if you are doing a session, make sure you keep it as one file. Start and then lap and then stop rather than start, stop, start, stop. It's just much easier. Okay, have a good weekend, team.